Welcome back again. Welcome to the second segment of our show, the one where we are exposing the false teachings of Talent Chiwenga. Now, in the first clip, I showed you that Talent says Noah got drunk, and his getting drunk was something which was in the plans of God, as you will hear him saying that. And then we saw that he says Noah cursed Ham's son, Canaan, which is true, but our aim is to know and to search for who is Canaan in the Bible. And then the last time I played the clip, you heard him talking about Canaan being somebody cursed, and we were pursuing for who Canaan was. So let's continue. Canaan is a vagabond. I've just gone a minute back. You heard this, but I'm just checking you so that we take him nicely. Yes, kumadoro kwakashata. Taking alcohol is bad. It's bad.
No, I'm out, but
you shouldn't have said that. You should have said you must not drink beer. Just hold it there. Okay, let's take it from here. Do you see? Listen to this. Okay. Did you hear that? He says, because of Noah's drunkenness. If you want to preach about moral issues concerning this issue of Noah getting drunk, you will misfire. So in other words, he's saying there is some spiritual meaning behind Noah's getting drunk. That's what he's implying. Let's go. Let's listen to what he's going to say about Noah's getting drunk. This is the gentleman I recorded a video on who says, Timothy, because of your often infirmities, take chateu. Take beer. This is the gentleman. So now here, listen to what he's saying. Now here he is saying, let me not preempt him. Just listen to what he's going to say about Noah and his beer problem. Listen. Did you hear what he says? Or what he said? He said, when Noah got drunk, his drunkenness has got a very serious meaning as far as his life and God's life was concerned, and Christ. So listen what it is. Listen to that. So do you hear that? So he's saying, because last night I was drunk, so it's a good thing that I must bless my sons after getting drunk. That's what he's saying. You can hear him. So now I've got a problem with that. So listen to that. So So do you hear now? He says, I want to bless and to curse because of alcohol. Listen to where he will be going. Listen to that.
No,
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 no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no, no,
So did you hear that? Where in the Bible is a blessing a result of getting drunk? You see what this clever lost preacher is trying to justify the consumption of alcohol, but the way he is doing it in such a way that these poor people can't see that this guy has got a dirty and dangerous doctrine about alcohol. So he says, Noah waited until he was drunk for him to bless his children. But now he's not only talking about the blessing now. He has now stopped talking about the blessing. He has stopped talking about the curse of Canaan. He's now talking in terms of Noah blessing his sons because he was drunk. Whereas the issue we know is that there was a curse which came as a result of him getting drunk. But do you know what he does? Because people cannot discern, he spins it and then he says there's a blessing out of getting drunk. Listen to what he was going to say. Listen to that.
Hallelujah.
Listen to this. Listen to this.
In our Tangira chapter 26, verse 28, Baba, Mukombe Uyu, Naiwapura. Akabega itaura pami vitwenda, itaura neva komana vasepeti. Bagagawa uya namaiva, wajukumbira utumumaisko kurujumu kuboshwe. Agata mukode kunwa mukombe wandura kunwa.
So now, listen to this, people of God. He is attaching the cup, which Jesus says, this cup, let it pass, oh God. So now, he is taking the drunkenness of Noah, and he is attaching that drunkenness to Jesus' cup. So now, sublimely, what he is saying is that Jesus' cup was full of beer, because he told the two sons of Zebedee that you can't drink that cup. So now, do you see now that the way he is constructing his sermon, it is a justification and a dangerous doctrine about the consumption of alcohol. So now, when you are saying Noah got drunk and he blessed his sons and he only did it and he says, I'll do it when I'm drunk, and then you take the Lord's cup and says, Jesus spoke about drinking a cup. Do you see that now he's saying Jesus drank beer? Listen to that.
I'm going to baptize when you baptize, when you baptize 1 hour. Panawi or Jesu Aitaura Kufa. Do righty, you baptize. Aitaura Kufa. Do Mkombe wa Aitaura Pagadiva.
So, do you hear that? Mkombe wa Jesu. No blesser. No akawakaita vana vake zvakafanana. Do you believe that? But by the way, our aim is we are looking for Canaan, but now here it's like we have diverted and we are talking of Noah's drunkenness and we are talking of the Lord's cup. Now, from the way I am hearing him, he is equating Noah's drunkenness and Jesus' cup as one. So in other words, Jesus was drinking beer. As far as I can deduce from what he said, that's me, you have your own right to deduce from what you understand from what he said. But my understanding is that Mkombe waitaura kwana Jesu. Ne doro akamwana Noah zvinhu zvimwe chete. Chiteerera kuti akazoti chii.
Mkombe waitaura wakanga uri kuva saka uchiona kuti panonzi wanga akashama Noa akangoshama bedzi akaita sei akadhakwa.
Okay, listen to this. Noah akamwa doro akadhakwa akashama mwana wake umwe akamuona ari naked. Noah consumed alcohol and he was naked, and one of his sons saw his nakedness, and that man who saw his nakedness, his son was cursed. And then now he is equating the cup of Christ, that when Christ was dying on the cross, that was the cup. And then his nakedness, that is Jesus on the cross, was a cup. So now he is equating Jesus' nakedness and Noah's nakedness as a result of alcohol and wine. Listen to what he was going to say. So Jesus Christ drank his cup, he got... So here is the question. Jesus was naked at that cross. Did he drink beer? And his nakedness, was it a result of his own or he was what? He was taken off, the clothes were taken off by force. It was not something which he did like voluntarily. Okay, I'm taking off my clothes like Noah who was drunk. So now, do you see that this is not the gospel of Jesus Christ which this man is preaching? If you believe that Noah's getting drunk and Jesus dying on the cross, it means one thing, and Jesus saying, let this cup pass. So the pass which was talking about was his death. And you think the cup of Jesus and the drunkenness of Noah is one, you have been deceived. This guy is telling lies. Listen to this. I will continue. So in other words, Jesus was getting drunk because Noah got drunk. Do you believe this? So listen, when Noah got drunk, it was because of the cross of Christ. It was a good thing. And you believe this, shame, and I'm sorry, and I feel for you. This is satanic. If you believe that when Noah got drunk, it has something to do with the cross of Christ, this man has deceived you. And better wake up very fast, because this is dangerous stuff. Nowhere in the Bible do you read of a place where beer and the cross go hand in hand. Now, if you believe this, it's your fault. Listen, that's not the end. He says, let's leave it like that. Listen to what he said.
Hallelujah. Saka, tanga chida muzina kuti nyika ya Kenan yakapiwa Abraham.
Back to our story. We are still here. We just sidetracked. Our issue was Kenan. I'm with him.
Kenan is the cursed one.
Yes, it's true.
Kenan, the worker too.
Kenan is cursed. Yes, the son of Ham.
But the Tatawa Tishakuronda Zinzara Abraham. Tikawana with the power, never know what you are to shame Ham and Japhet. Abraham ano Vakuna shame. We are Kanziga could be Maria shame. Could ever put a shame, Muropa Falto among I. Abraham land ya anofanira kunge akapa kuna akaropa fato. Indava. Munozviziva here vadikani kuti land ye Canaan iland ye akatukwa waMwari.
Okay. For the sake of putting this straight for some of us who don't understand, Sean, he is saying the land of Canaan is cursed. Yes, that is what the Bible teaches. So let's continue and follow him, because the land of Canaan is cursed. Which is the land of Canaan? Let me explain. Listen to that.
Mizraim, munozviziva here kuti ndiye akavaka Egypt.
Okay. Did you hear that? Now what he has done, he has flip-flopped from Ham. Instead of concentrating with Canaan, who is not in Africa, he goes to who? To one of the sons of Ham, who is what? Mizraim, which is Egypt. When he is saying Mizraim built Egypt, yes, Mizraim is the founder of Egypt, Africa. Listen to what he said. We are looking for Canaan, not Mizraim. Did you hear that? Okay, that's where the problem starts. He is saying Africa belongs to the children of Canaan. Is it true? The answer is no. Africa belongs to Mizraim, Put, and Cush, those three. Canaan is not in Africa. Canaan is in Sidon, where Tyre and Sidon, Lebanon, Jordan, Syria, and the parts of Middle East. So when you are talking of Canaan, you are not talking of Africa. So how on earth he is saying the Canaanites are Africans? It's a shock. Because even today, if you Google, you go on Google and you say Canaan, you will see that Canaan is not in is not Africa. It's where? Jordan, Tyre, Sidon. It's even called Phoenicia, the Phoenicians. Oh, those are the Canaanites. Today, we can call them the Palestinians or the Phoenicians or the Canaanites. Not the Africans. The Africans are Cush, Mizraim, and Put. Canaan never went to Egypt. Canaan never went to Sudan. Canaan never went to Ethiopia. He is still in the land of Canaan. And the land of Canaan is not in Africa. He is telling a lie. And the people are clapping hands. Let's continue. So you see now, these people, the African people, is my brothers and my sisters. They are clapping hands and he's telling them that they are cursed. These are Zimbabweans. You know who's this? These are the children of Nimrod, the descendants of Cush. Cush had a son called Nimrod, a mighty hunter. Nimrod is the one who spread as far as Southern Africa to South Africa, Zimbabwe, Botswana. Canaan has nothing to do with Zimbabwe. So now these guys, they think they are Canaanites and they think they are cursed. And listen to what he said about them. No! Africans are not children of Canaan. It's a lie. He's telling lies. So do you believe that you are a child, as an African, you are a child of Canaan? No! Canaanites are not from Africa. And he's lying. And these guys are enjoying. And he's lying to them. Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, my issue is that this guy is deceiving people. The Canaanites are not in Africa. Canaan is in the Middle East. Tyre, Sidon, Jordan, Lebanon. That's Canaan for you. So he is saying Canaan are the Africans, and they are clapping hands. And he is telling them that you are cursed because you are Canaan. And they are not Canaan. They are Cush, they are Nimrod. Listen to that. No, that's not true. Yes, Canaan is cursed. Let me tell you about the Canaanites, the Palestinians today. Their case, they are under shame. If you remember, in Genesis chapter 9, the Bible says, and then God says, blessed be the God of shame. Who is going to be leader of who? Who is going to be the leader of who? of Ham, who is going to be the leader of Canaan. So the Canaanites are going to be the servants of a man whose God is the God of Shem. And who is that? Israel. So you go to Israel today, the Canaanites, the Palestinians, they don't even have a currency of their own. When Israel cuts the border, they don't even have money. They don't even have food. They don't even have factories. Even bread, they get bread from Israel. When they fight Israel and Israel closes its border, they have nothing. These are the Canaanites. And he's saying the Canaanites are black people, and he's lying. Does it end there? No. Let's continue and listen.
Africa in Marombe kupfuura any other continent under the sun.
Do you know what he says? He is saying, if you look at it carefully, you will discover that Africa is cursed. It has got vagabonds. It has got useless people. Why? Because they are the descendants of Canaan, which is a lie. We are not the descendants of Israel. If you are an African who knows your Bible, you will be angry by what this man is saying. Because he is saying you are cursed. With all the diamonds, with all the gold, with all the metals in Africa, Africa is not cursed. And he even started by saying the land of Canaan belongs to a man called Canaan. So are you telling me, Chiwenga, that Africa is Canaan? You know, when you want to know the simple information about who Canaan is, the children of Israel were in captivity in Africa for 400 years. You remember the story of Joseph? When he went to sell corn, that's when he settled, and his father came, and they settled, and they started multiplying. And then when they were a nation, God says, I will take you to the promised land of Canaan. Was he taking them to Africa? No. Where was he taking them? Israel. So he is saying Canaan is in Africa. And you believe him. And then you see what I do. When I stand up and I tell you guys that this guy is deceiving you, you say, ah, you hate preachers. You hate pastors. Why are you talking bad about pastors? Here is a pastor. He is deceiving his own brothers. And the brothers are even believing his gospel that they are cursed when they are not cursed. So here is my issue if you are listening. This guy is misleading people. We African people, we are not Canaanites. We are the descendants of Nimrod, the descendants of Cush, the descendants of Mizraim, the descendants of Put, the descendants of Cush. We are not cursed. Cursed is Canaan in Israel. Let's go. Thank you. We are not children of Canaan. Black people are not children of Canaan. Do your own research. He's still repeating. He says, blacks, we are the children of Canaan. That's not true. Black people are not the children of Canaan. If you believe that you are a child of Canaan, you have been deceived, because history, just go and say Google and say Canaan and see where Canaan is. It's not in Africa. So don't believe him. He's lying.
People.
He says, let us look for the descendants of Canaan. I want to follow him. Yes. Who is Canaan? Yes.
Canaan
was Sidon.
Is Sidon in Africa? Because those are the children of Canaan. Have you ever heard of a country in Africa called Sidon, Tyre and Sidon? Just Google for your own homework. Say Tyre and Sidon. Sidon was a son to Canaan. Is Sidon in Africa? Answer me, brothers and sisters. You see, when I tell you that this guy is misleading people, I am not framing him. I don't harbor hatred. I'm a child of God. All I want to do is to help my brothers and my sisters. You see, the picture of Africa is painful in that the people like this man take advantage of ignorant people. You see, these guys, most of them are not at work, and I wish God could do something for them. And only to gather around a man who is deceiving them. Brothers, as you hear this man preaching to you, he is lying to you. You are not Canaanites. You are the descendants of Mizraim. You are the descendants of Cush. You are the descendants of Mizraim. You are the descendants of Nimrod. You are not cursed. Africa is not cursed. Canaan is not in Africa. So this guy is lying. Don't believe him. Is Sidon in Africa? Listen, Sidon is the father-in-law of King Ahab. Sidon is the father of Jezebel. Is Sidon from Africa? Was Jezebel in Africa? He's lying. Sidon is not in Africa. Ahab is not in Africa. Ashtaroth is not in Africa. The Baals were not served in Africa. Listen to this.
Nekuti mwana sikana wa Ethbaal mambo Sidon Jezebel ndi akanga azoita mukadzi wa Ahab, the king of Israel.
So where does Ahab, Jezebel and Sidon go in Africa? Where do they come in? Where do they come in? Sidon and Jezebel and Ahab. Have they any African links? No, he is lying.
Sidon, you know, no matter Ashtoreth.
Is Ashtoreth in Africa? Listen.
Iyo Sidon, you know, Tyre and Sidon.
These are Tyre and Sidon are the children of who? Of Canaan. They are not in Africa. So is it in Africa? So listen, brothers and sisters. He says Tyre and Sidon are the countries which were at enmity with God. Are these countries in Africa? No. Let's continue. So now he is mixing Herod and the king of Tyre and Sidon, and I don't even know how to put it. That where is Africa in all this? Why he is saying this? You know why? Because these people he's preaching to don't research. Brothers and sisters, Mazimbabwe, did you hear me? Ilamanga. Amazangu. Blazo awa. Waruku kunyepe rai. Blazo awa. Waruku nyepa. Sidona haisi ku Africa. Kenan haisi ku Africa. Kenan akatukwa haisi ku Africa. Saka kana iwe. Uchifunga kutu wakatukwa uri Kenan. Indava zako. Kenan haisi mu Africa. Ndawa. Ingo. Pafoni pako ingo gugula uti Kenan. Uchona uti Kenan haisi mu Africa. Asahabu na kudini. Aatacha. Ahamu, kuti mwana wake ndi Kenan, akamuti Kenan ndi Africa. When Kenan is not in Africa, akanyepa. And vanhu vari kushira maoko. Why? These preachers, they have got agendas of deceiving people. Ahamu saw his father's nakedness. Ahamu's son Kenan was cursed. And Kenan is not in Africa. Kenan is in the Middle East. So if you believe this guy, you are going to be deceived. Thank you. Let's continue.
Muzivo yokawa vakanga vanzwana nevakaita the Nan Aggression Pact yavo vakazouya akakuzoita mabiko ekupemberera rugare pakati pa Herode na mambo etire na mambo Sidon. Apa Herode akanga uraya ma apostle James aitori name ropa moko makaranga riri fresh.
Let me just cut this and summarize this. Amadzangu vanave kuZimbabwe. Kana ndichi kwikwidzana nomurume uyu andimuvengi. He's just a young man. I look at him as my son. But when I'm trying to warn you about this boy, I do it out of love. I have nothing I want from this young man. I have not been in Zimbabwe for more than 20 years and I have nothing I want from him. But all I want to help you with is that this guy is lying. Zvese zvakutaura kuti Lot kuti Noah akakomborera vanhu akadhakwa muchinjikwa is a lie. An average person knows that that's nonsense. And anozozviattacha nomukombe unonzi naJesu, mukombe wandinomwa kana kuti kapi yandinomwa hamukwanisi kuimwa, ozoda kuti attacha kuti mukombe waimwa naJesu idoro. And then ozoti nakedness yakazoonekwa naJesu pamuchinjikwa amwa mukap paakaroverwa, it has something to do with Noah. It's a lie, brothers and sisters. So what am I trying to say? Do you know, I've been, the day I started listening to this preacher, when he was exposing false prophets like Vana Makandiwa, Vana Guti, Vana Utaunashe, Vana Magaya, I was so happy. I thought, yeah, I even wrote him an inbox letter like, brother, thank you for being humble and for exposing these wolves. And I would be pindura. Pandakazotanga kunyatsa kuteresesa so ndokatanzanzudzwa kuti no zvarutaura zvinotove dondo rinotofora vana Makandiwa vari nani, because Makandiwa azofi akakutaurira kuti Noah akadhakwa akablesa vanhu nokuti akakadhakwa anoziva kuti mablessings haana doro. But uyo atove so extreme, and ndikutaurira isoka agenda yaanayo mufana uyu. His agenda is very dangerous, because his agenda iagenda inozosvisa vanhu pakuti imwai doro, hapana chakaipa nokumwa doro. And when you talk to people and you tell them that Noah akablesa vanhu akadhakwa nototi kudhakwa ndokwakaita kuti ablese vanhu, this is nonsense. So what am I trying to tell you about this, young brothers and sisters? I have listened to nearly maybe 10 of his videos. Unoza kutenda kwandiri ndichiita so ndee ndichitozvifosa kuti I think 2-3 weeks ago there have been a gentleman from Zimbabwe angachindifonera nearly every 2 days. From Zimbabwe phone me that I heard your videos about Doro Nechiwenga inoenda kushecha Chiwenga. How come? I debated with him kusvika ndatoona kuti zviri nani ndi release a video and then put this thing straight. If I can tell you mukatenderera video yanotaura pamusoro pekenani iyoyi, yanotaura pamusoro pezvimwe zvinhu mafuniro anoita magwaro nezvaanotaura, unongona kuti hazvina mweya mutsvene mukati. So what is my case, brothers in Zimbabwe? My case is this guy is a deceiver. Kenani haisi muAfrica. Kenani yakatukwa haisi Africa yakatukwa. Ndinokutendai, Mwari akukomborerei, Mwari akuwedzerei. Vasina mabasa hama dzangu, ndinokunamatira kuti Mwari akupe mabasa. Asi musanyengerwa nomukomana wenyu. Thank you.